bring you up to meet, it's how we always do it, meet with our general manager, Robert.
Okay.
And then after that, I'll give you a call and let you know.
Now it tells me it's new.
Yeah.
Just trying to figure out.
So these, yeah, we had a little bitty facility, I don't know if you remember, it was down the road. There's an enterprise there now.
Oh.
Building. Yeah, about 3 years ago, and then, 3.5 years ago. And they built these, but we were down almost, what was that, the other side of Nissan, it was a whole building.
So in Texas, you have to have pad and paper on a, there's two different forms.
And this is Robert.
Give me a couple minutes for a bit.
Yeah, no problem.
I'm just gonna be. You doing all right today?
Yes, sir.
Excellent. So I guess you, saw our ad in.
Indeed.
Okay. So, just tell me just a little bit about yourself and what you've been doing and.
Doing all kinds of stuff, basically anything they needed.
What exactly is a edger?
A machine edger. They have these big machines that are called edgers, and they cut the lens down to fit in the frames. Puts a bevel on the edge.
Like glasses?
Yes.
Oh, okay. Oh, okay. Gotcha. And so you were there for several years?
Yeah, I mean, that's a lot of people have been in that, in that position. That's been a big change, obviously, for everybody. So, I'm sure Tony kind of, I'm sure, told you, kind of what we're looking for. Just a little bit about, are you from this area, or have you lived here all your life? Or?
I'm originally from Houston.
So you probably have heard the Huffines name around. I mean, we've been around.
Sure.
It's coming up on 100 years, started
wow.
here in Denton, but anyway, we're still, family-owned and operated. We have built, over that period of time, a really great reputation, and we've just really since, our business has changed a little bit, car sales have changed a little bit, we're selling cars before they come in, and anyway, just as a result of some of the stuff that's going on, we've really been more focused on customer experience and that kind of thing, and so we and team member experience as well. And Tony and I have discussed for some time the fact that we really need we don't really have an hourly person that is specifically designated to help facility wise. So we grab his valets or porters a lot of times, to do something over here, do something over there. But we're 55,000 square feet total, I think. Anyway, we built these facilities about 3.5 years ago, and we've just really felt the need to have somebody that is working on a daily basis to upkeep things. Maybe do minor repairs and stuff like that, and just help us out with groundskeeping and facility keeping and all that kind of stuff. So we moved from down to our old facility, like I said, about 3.5 years ago. We really didn't need anybody there because you couldn't have kept that one very nice as hard as you tried. It was just old.
Wow.
They tore it down. It's now the enterprise location down there, but obviously, these facilities we want to keep looking as good as possible, and have it a nice presentation for our customers and that kind of thing. So, it looks like, particularly to me, your work at UNT is kind of more along the lines of what we're looking for here. Just additional cleaning shop. Upkeep, grounds management. I mean, just nice. God, man, there's more trash that blows up here off the freeway, it seems like, than you can imagine. So, from that to helping around the facility, it's kind of what we're looking for. So, has what Tony mentioned to you as far as you know, an hourly rate or whatever? I mean, does that sound like what you were looking for, or have you all discussed that?
No, we haven't discussed it. Okay. We haven't discussed that at all.
I didn't know, and I'm not even sure. He's really kind of been helping me with this, you know, facilitate this. Well, I do think there's plenty to keep somebody busy. I will say that it helps to have somebody that is kind of a self-starter, that where, you know, we can kind of give you, you know, a list of things, you know, to do on a daily basis or whatever, and then just kind of a self-starter, you know, that doesn't require a lot of supervision.
Yeah.
I mean, and so if that's kind of what you were used to before, then that sounds like that might.
Yeah, I mean, we're not looking for somebody we have to direct constantly, for sure. I mean, let's,
as long as I have a little direction. I don't want to be just completely abandoned. But
yeah, here we go. and, you know, it could also actually include, you know, although we don't have as much of it to do, but, you know, lot arrangement and moving cars and even, you know, running customers sometimes or whatever. I mean, it could just, there's a lot of different things where we find ourselves in need of an additional, you know, staff person to help out. So, yeah. Okay, well, I will say, I mean, we do, we work hard at trying to make it a good place to work. You know, we do, just so you know, we participate in the, I don't know if I have it up here, I don't in this office anymore, but in the top 100 places to work through the Dallas Morning News. Every year we participate in that. Basically, it's based on all on team member feedback. So we do a survey every year, and then compile all the results and act on that stuff to try to make it a better place to work. We've been in the top 100 places to work for the last 8 or 10 years in a row. So we do actively, you know, work at making it a good place to work. I've been here for in November it'll be 18 years. We've got a lot of long-term people here. Got a really good team. So, you know, if you're looking for some place to fit in, and we do lots of community work up here as well. That you might be asked to help out with, you know, from time to time, things like that. You know, set up and tear down different things. Whatever. So
awesome! Excellent.
So. I like to just visit with any, you know, prospective team member, so that if you like I said, I'm kind of deferring to Tony on this one, but if you show up and you're working, then I'll know who you are and what you're doing here.
Well, I really appreciate your time, the opportunity to meet you.
I appreciate your taking time to visit with us, and I will turn you back over to Tony, and he can answer any additional questions for you. From there, but I do appreciate you coming in, and
thank you so much. I'm very excited about that.
Good. Looks like you've got, you know, some of the stuff that we're looking for sure. So
thank you so much.
We appreciate it. You know where he is?
Yes, sir. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
10 miles away, it's easy. My new desk just got delivered.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Desk.